In my previous video, I talked about transparency and how it affects our relationship. Now, there are so many aspects of transparency, that's being open or bearing it out to your partner. One major aspect of this transparency is the financial aspect, which is the most important aspect actually in your relationship when it comes to being transparent. Now, how you handle your finances in your relationship or your marriage can either make it or mar it. If you've not watched my video on transparency, please go back and watch it after this. Thank you. In this video, I'll be talking about financial infidelity and all you need to know about it. How to know when you are faulting and do you know you are actually cheating with money? So what is financial infidelity? Financial infidelity has to do with you spending money, borrowing money, making money, in fact, everything that has to do with money. You're doing these things without the knowledge of your partner. It entails you hiding stuffs about money, hiding your unemployment or hiding your employment from your partner. You might have your reasons for doing this, but then we'll find out if those reasons outweigh the importance of your relationship in the long run. Feel comfortable hiding expenses from your partner. When you feel comfortable hiding your debt from your partner, hiding your unemployment, you just lost a job but you could not bring yourself to tell your partner. When you feel comfortable about increasing the price or reducing the price of what you bought to your partner, then you are cheating on them. You're guilty of financial infidelity. Now, you might have your reason. You might have your reason that, okay, because my partner does not know how to save, or he or she spends recklessly, or this or that. But there is no benefit at all in lying to your partner. No matter how you choose to go about it, as far as you're hiding stuffs from your partner, you're hiding money, you're lying about money, you're not being honest with your expenses or with your income or with your savings, as far as you are lying, you are destroying your relationship. Younger couples are more prone to commit this crime, this financial infidelity, because of course they just got into the relationship or into the marriage, and then they notice that, okay, my partner is not on the same line with me financially. So how do I go about this? I have to start hiding. Now, mind you, I'm here to bring to your notice that there are better ways to go about it. There are better ways to deal with that relationship issue. Because if you are at a stage where you cannot be honest enough, where you cannot tell your partner about your expenses, the A to Z about your expenses, then trust me, you have a relationship issue. And lying will only bring up more problems, because one, your partner, you don't trust your partner, and your partner won't also trust you. Because of course, you might think that that partner is not aware of the fact that you're hiding some stuffs, but let it shock you that that partner might know but decide to, okay, since you don't trust me enough, or since you don't think that I'm good enough to know about these stuffs, let me just let it be. So you'll be creating more problems. You'll be creating lack of trust in your relationship, and where there is lack of trust, of course, there will be less progress. Now, there are better ways to go in about this. We all know that two good heads are better than one. Now, imagine you get married to someone that is on the same financial pace with you, but then because of your pride or maybe your personal issues, you just feel like you need to stock up this cash in secret in case of the rainy day. Have you thought of a case whereby if you had let your partner in on what you want to do, or these savings, maybe they would have preferred more solutions or more ways to actually go about this. Two good heads are better than one in a relationship. When you know that your partner is one that also has the same dream with you, I see no need for you to actually hide stuffs about money from them. Now, the main problem lies in a relationship whereby both partners are not on the same level. Now, that's where the main problem lies. And then one of the partner or both of them might resort to lying, because of course, if I'm the type that spends and my husband doesn't like me spending, I'll tend to hide how much I earn. I'll tend to reduce the price of what I bought so it doesn't seem like, okay. Or if my partner is the type that likes to save, and I'm the type that likes to spend, he would save behind my back because he knows that when I find out about the savings, oh, I would like to spend it. So this is where the problem is. But trust me, there are better ways to solve this than lying. Of course, if you have the interest of that marriage or that relationship at heart, you would want to look for solutions to your problem, to the problem of this financial infidelity that is slowly eating up your relationship. Now, the first thing to do, we can never overemphasize the importance of communication. In every issue you have, communication is key. Now, call your partner, sit your partner down and have that mutual discussion, have that heart-to-heart talk with your partner. Discuss, lay out your fears. Okay, look at, I'm not being open. I lie to you about these things. I lie to you about my finances and how much I earn. Because when I say it all, you tend to be so over-demanding. Or I do this, I just explain everything to your partner. Communicate to them and listen to their own opinions also. Listen to what they also have to say. Now, communicate your long-term and short-term goals with each other. Know your weaknesses and strengths. If one partner is the saver and the other partner is the spender, you just have to come to that compromise. Reach that compromise. Of course, you cannot just work and then you will not expect to spend, of course, and you won't just spend without expecting to save. I believe every reasonable person will be able to come to that compromise. Okay, for our short-term goal, let's see, okay, in a month we should be able to be open. Let's know how much comes into this house and how much goes out. Okay, but for your expenses, please, can we not spend above this? Okay, for saving, can we make a target of saving this? At least it will help to reach both partners will be at peace that, okay, you don't have a problem with my spending as far as I don't go above this. But in case of any emergency, you will still let your partner know. He or she would understand because you've already explained your stand to that partner. Now, for your long-term goals, you might choose that, okay, we want to build a house or want to start up a company or for our pension, for our retirement or any other thing. You just, okay, you map out a plan and carry both partners along. Two of you should carry yourself along. By so doing, you will achieve more. You achieve more because two of you will be cooperative to the plan. And then you achieve more with peace of mind without having to hide or fear that, oh, if my partner finds out about this. Because trust me, financial infidelity has destroyed so many marriages. There are some people that get married and then the wife later finds out that this man I got married to does not have a job. He has been borrowing just to get me. He borrowed for the wedding. He borrowed for everything. What do you expect of such marriage? So you would agree with me that lying does not solve anything. It only compounds the problem. Choose to lie about your finance, or you might choose to maybe hide some things about money from your partner because of fear or because of embarrassment. Maybe you were just laid off from work and then you feel so embarrassed that, how can I face my partner and tell him or her that, okay, I just got laid off, and you choose to lie. Why? Address every problem as they arise. You were just laid off from work, you just lost your job. As you reach home, tell your partner. You don't need to hide that, okay, in less than 1 month I'll get another job, and then he or she would not find out. Because you won't get a job in that same place. How would you explain that you had to change from one company to another? Of course, you will still have to say it later in the future that I lost my job and so on. But address every problem as you come. And you losing your job would even make your partner to be more compassionate, to be more, okay, I need to cover up for the meantime. I need to step in because my partner's income would eventually reduce as he or she has lost the job. So I have to step in. So it will only make your partner to be more compassionate and less overbearing towards. We all want to be in a healthy, peaceful relationship, a relationship that can serve as a place of rest and heaven for us, but we have to put in the work. And this issue of financial infidelity is one that is not common because maybe people do not know about it, or they feel that, okay, it's my money, I don't think I should come out open. But no, you being in a relationship with somebody, especially marriage, it means you are one. There is no my money or your money. It's our money. And our money should be open. There should be no lying with our money. It's not important for you to even have a joint account for you to be open in money issues, because there are some couples that have joint accounts, but still they are guilty of financial infidelity. So joint account does not even guarantee anything. The main thing is you and your partner having that conversation, having that communication that, okay, we have to be open. If I spend 5 naira, my partner should know about it. If I want to send this money to anybody, my partner should know about it. It will reduce trust, or that distrust, that doubt in the mind that how did this money get missing? How did this money reduce to this level? How did this happen? So it will reduce that, and you'll be able to face more serious things, because money contributes to majority of the problems that people have in their relationship, that people face, both the rich and the poor. Money contributes to more than 50% of relationship problems. So you should be able to reduce these problems by not telling lies, at least the one that we can control. Let's be able to control it and give ourselves that peaceful and healthy relationship. So this is my opinion on this issue. If you have any suggestion or any question, please feel free to drop it in the comment section for me. And please, as you're watching this video, if you know you like my video, just help me and subscribe, please. By so doing, you'll be supporting me and encouraging me to produce more videos. Please don't also forget to like and share this video. Thank you. And for those that are already subscribed, please, you can hit the notification bell so that you can get notifications as I release videos. Okay, so we'll see in the next video. Bye for now.